I am completely in love with Grimgar right now, dude. I just need to get this off of my chest before we move forward with the review. This episode was beautiful. It was perfection as far as I was concerned. I'm just in love. Grimgar is easily in my top three this season now. Just done. I love Dimension W. Needs to move down to number four, though, because Grimgar is incredible. The first episode, you know, drew me in. It captivated me with this world and especially with the characters. You know, the stylization, the aesthetic, the art style and animation. A1 is making the series and this world look sexy. And I love the pacing and, you know, how, you know, the slow, bit by bit, this fantasy world is starting to be fleshed out as we get to know it alongside our characters who have just been cast into it. The dichotomy between their current selves and their lost memories and everything like that. Just the questions I have, but what really, the music is godly, and I'll get into that later, but what really had me in the first episode and what was perpetuated here is the characters and seeing them grow, seeing them, you know, come to terms with this new world, and seeing the details and the intricacies of the dynamic between them and them forming a bond and learning, like this episode, the exploration of, you know, life and death and the importance of that and what it truly means to take a life, how they were all affected by that. That scene with the goblin was done so well. It absolutely was executed perfectly, and that's how I feel about the entirety of this episode and the pacing of it, the slow pace and the focus. Like, if you're just an action head and you just want to see this, you know, kind of MMO style fantasy world where people are going in, this is not going to be for you. And I can see some people having problems with Grimgar, but what I'm seeing in this episode, it's real. It's going, I guarantee there will be feels. And from what I've heard from light novel readers, without having been spoiled, and please nobody spoil it, but I've heard that shit goes in and that, you know, there are heavy feels, tragedy awaits, and that it gets even darker. And based on this episode and the scene with the goblin, it was quite dark. It was teetering that line. And if that's just the beginning, and especially as we grow with our characters and become more attached, which I'm loving every single character of the main cast right now, it's going to be crazy. So, Hayato Tensono Grimgar episode 2. I just loved every aspect of this episode, and like I said, I really enjoy the slow pace and the focus on the characters and seeing them come to terms with this world and interact with it, you know, from the very beginning of the episode with that conversation between Minato and Haruhito, and, you know, they're basically, Minato has been going around the town, going to this tavern, Shelley's Tavern, and drinking and everything like that, just the laid-back nature of their conversation, and at the same time, you know, developing each character and getting us more insight into their persona. And I love the vague visceral feelings, you know, towards their lost memories that, you know, kind of you see them trying to struggle with that and recall that in reference to their current selves. It's beautiful, dude. Just seeing them sit under the night sky and have this heart to heart and everything like that. I was like, this is, it started the episode perfectly. This is exactly what I want to see. OP, I fucking love it, and the OST as a whole, I don't know who's doing the OST as a whole, but that one track, the no-name tracks, the opening, the ending, and that one track that played as they were going in and fumbling around against the goblin, fucking sexy, dude. It was reminiscent of some Shoji Meguro stuff, no lie, for a second there for me. That's how much I'm loving the OST as well, and especially during that montage sequence, you know, where they were all each enjoying their afternoon separately, which I'm gonna get into in a second. But let's go back to the scene with the goblin, man, which, fucking Ranta, man, I love Ranta. You know, the spirit of young Favreau imbued inside of him, and the comedy with him is hilarious, but seeing him flail around like a fool, I mean, it got real, and I'll get to that in a second, but seeing him flail around like a fool and fuck up the planet, I was just like, oh my god. And that's what I love about these characters. They each have their quirks to them and everything like that. Even though they do fall into these common archetypes, which is to be expected, I'm loving each and every one of them, and I can't wait to see them grow and see how they interact, which we'll get into all of that in a second. But they go in against this goblin. You see all of them making, you know, errors left and right. Shihoru missing her spell attacks, you know, the mismatch, the not paying attention to their surroundings, the mismatch with classes with, you know, Haruhito going as the thief first and everything like that, Ranta flailing around and fucking up. Eventually, you know, because of, at the end of the day, Minato was the pillar of this organization, and he was able to, you know, allow them to surround it, and then Mogozo was able to take it out. Granted, it still survived, and that's where shit got real, you know. Even Haruhito in his mind, like, he's like, even I can, I love the dialogue in that scene, he's like, even I could understand what he meant, you know, clinging to his life. I'll kill you before you can kill me. And just that inspection and that theme running through it, you know, the importance of life and death and you know, having to take this life for them to survive. And, you know, doing what it takes for your own survival, it was real. It was fucking real. And seeing Ranta just go crazy after it slashes at his leg in its death throes. And he's going, and that's the thing, I had the feels for the goblin and the kind of humanization for the monsters as well. Because even last episode, where you saw them, you know, all sitting around the fire, you know, drinking together. Or even here, just this lone goblin trying to get himself something to drink. I'm just like, this is something that you never really see in a kind of fantasy world, you know, piece of fiction. Where they're really getting into and kind of, you know, making you feel for the monsters and also using that, like, for them to realize, like, this is a life. This is, we're killing right now. And it's not just something that's, you know, okay, we're in this world, let's go slice them, dice them, like Renji and his group are doing, which they're badass. I'm not gonna fault them. They get the job done. Can't wait to get into them. But that aside, just seeing how it affected our cast of characters and seeing them and how they're gonna grow from it and everything like that. And at the same time, how this was their first kill and they are getting better and everything like that slowly. I love that inspection. So, first part of the episode for me was amazing. And then the second part, I think that montage was so well executed. Playing the ending there alone, but seeing, you know, everybody kind of moving on from that scene, Ranta kind of ruminating on, you see it was affecting him, he's kind of brooding over the fact that he took this life, even though he's like, oh, my first vice, I get to summon this demon and everything, which sounds dope, it really does. Dark Knight class is beast, I'm not gonna lie, but, you know, the shopping scene between Yume and Shihoru, I fucking love, you guys know how I feel about Yume and the voice actress and all, but Shihoru right now, and the comedy there was amazing, just that solo scene where you see her pull out these, like, little string pantsu and everything like that, and she's like, try these on, and Shihoru starts blushing. I'm just like, that is amazing. You know, you get to see a bit of Minato chilling by himself, and he comes over, dude, making moves, man. Minato coming over and making moves on Jihoro. I'm like, yo, is that the... And the thing is, like, I don't even know how to feel about this parent. I can't tell. I love, you know, the detail and how they showcase, you know, Yume's expressions and everything like that, because I can't tell if at the end of the day she was worried about Shihoru or she was jealous. And she has feelings for Minato. Either way, you saw that kind of forced smile, and she just leaves them alone, ultimately trying to be a good friend to both of them and everything like that. So, I fucking love Yume for that. But I'm not opposed to this Minato and Shihoru pairing, because Shihoru is fucking amazing. And I do like Minato's character, especially after this episode, even though I do have this kind of off feeling about it, and I'll get into that in quite a second. The reason I don't know about this pairing is simply because there's one or two ways I feel Minato's character is going to go, and it's going to be felt to be the way they are kind of pseudo cliche, but I mean, if they don't happen, it just turns out, okay, I would love that, and then it's all good, Minato ex Shihoru. But I either feel that Minato will be one of the first of them to die, because I feel from, you know, how this series is structured and everything like that, there's going to be heavy feels and tragedy in the future. And we still don't know what, you know, much about this world overall in terms of how it relates to their original world, you know, their lost memories, if this is in fact a game, if this is another realm, even though I'm leading towards it actually being a game. But I doubt they actually revive. If you die, you die. And that's, I think, what the weight was stressed in the early part of this episode, the weight of taking the goblin's life and everything like that. So either Minato's going to be the first to die, or his true colors are going to be revealed somewhere down the line. He actually turns out to be a grade A fiend. Those kind of vibes I get from this kind of character, but I still really like him based on what I saw and the way he kind of looks out for the group as a whole and related to Haruhiro and everything like that. So I'm fine with him and Shihoru. Then you got to see a bit of Mogozo, you know, what his daily routine, you know, cleaning his blade and whatnot. You see him carving this small airplane, which I wonder if that kind of harkens to his memories, carving this wooden airplane. Maybe, you know, he had a love for aviation, maybe he was a pilot himself, although he seems too young for that, but maybe he always wanted to fly or some shit like that in his previous life before they got to this world. Similarly, like with Minato and his taste for alcohol and everything like that, just these little subtle tells and signs that these things were these feelings that they have, which is all visceral and nothing they can really put their finger on. I love seeing that, and it's going to be amazing to see that kind of crop up as they also form this bond and develop in this world and everything like that. So I love the montage sequence. It is amazing. I just love the pacing of this series. I mean, Yes, down the line when shit starts to go in, like seeing Randy's group, seeing once they start to really develop in, you know, the later parts of the series and everything like that, I would love to see some GOAT action sequences. And even the little skirmish with the goblin looked amazing to me. I really, A1 is going in right now. So in this season overall, A1 is fucking going to have two series at the, now this is why I say it all the time about them, man. It's a matter, of course, of budget and of how many series they actually have to do in any given course of a quarter. So that aside, man, I think Grimgar is fucking amazing. I know some people are gonna hate on it. I know the light novel, you know, readers are loving this adaptation, and I'm glad. I'm loving the pacing. I can't wait to see where it goes. Like, for this early on, for me to be invested enough to where I'm like, I definitely see myself wanting to read these light novels once the season ends. That's fucking incredible. So I think that's pretty much everything I wanted to talk about. I mean, I just, and of course, I like the little dialogue, that last scene with Ranta going to peep on them and everything in the bath. The man's like, yo, he's like, I have passion. I was just like, yo, his little monologues. Ranta's fucking amazing. I do love him, but I love all the characters. Haruhito, seeing how he was affected by, you know, the goblin scene and everything like that, and killing this goblin, you know, Minato, you know, Shihoru, Yume, Moguzo. Mogozo has the least characterization, but I think he got a good bit of spotlight in that montage, to where I know a little bit more about Mogozo, even though he barely says anything throughout the entire series so far. And Ranta, of course, like I said, but that shit was awesome, and it was nice to see. And also that little bit of comedy, you know, between Minato and Haruhito, where they're talking about their training, everything like that. So it was a nice episode overall. I really loved it. I thought it was an amazing episode. It was beautiful. And I'm in love with Grimgar. That's all I can say right now. So let me know your thoughts on this series. And I'm out. Peace.